But yeah, for anybody that's just tuning in, we're, you know, starting the Firewatch stream. We just left off on day three, where Henry, you know, just found out his watchtower was vandalized. You know, we've already seen a bunch of banter between he and Delilah, the other lookout that's kind of his boss slash coworker. And he's been talking to her, telling her a little bit about himself. Or I've been allowing that to happen because, of course, you can make choices as to what you tell Delilah. But yeah, this is the ransacked.
Hey,
oh, let's listen.
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Do you know Raleigh Fingers? You pitched for the A's?
No.
Well, I'm the spitting image of him.
Oh, wait, is he the guy with the snidely whiplash thing going on from the 70s? Ooh, my dad loved him.
Yeah, that's him.
That mustache. Now you have my attention.
Okay.
Okay? That's really
okay.
Weird.
Well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, you know, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Tuxedos, as often as possible.
Oh, really?
You bet.
How cosmopolitan. I didn't realize Boulder was so chic.
It is the peak of high society.
Well, it kind of is. Kind of is.
No deal, yes. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
Well, I have a thin mustache. Real thin mustache. I got a long scar. It goes down across my eye and down my cheek.
And you only wear tuxes?
Yeah.
Are you a freaking Bond villain?
I get up to some stuff, yeah.
I don't think you're taking this very seriously.
Of course not.
I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
She's drawing me?
What?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
They look tired, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, you hit a certain age and you think you're a younger person who just looks tired all the time.
Speak for yourself, mister.
I guess that's getting old.
Well, some people might see distinguished. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
Well, yeah, that's kind of a little, example of the kind of banter that they've had between them. And their conversations get a little more interesting every time I hear them. But anyway, he's been talking to this park ranger lady, or other lookout lady, and, you know, again, I've been allowing him to share some parts of his story as far as, you know, what happened with his wife, who had early onset dementia. Then he sort of, you know, messed up one day by, you know, leaving her alone in the house, and then his in-laws had to come and pick her up, and they never liked him to begin with, but of course that made them hate him. So what I'm doing right now, I think my task is to find some more, boards, because I'm boarding up the ransacked watchtower. I'm trying to fix the window, but I don't know where any more boards are. Oh, there's one. Wait, there's several here. Okay, there we go. Board up, broken window. Was there another one? Yes. Okay, cool beans. So yeah, we're gonna board up the window. When he was looking for the teenagers, he discovered that the phone line had been cut, apparently, by the teenagers. So I don't think they're missing. You know, right now we just sort of think that they might have done this. And then there was a suspicious man that we came across who was shining, I think, a flashlight in our faces. So didn't really know who it was. Couldn't really tell. There we go. And final window. Or final board.
I got that window all patched up. So what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
Well, yeah.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task, and I'll give it to you.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
You know, I'm gonna hike around for a while before I really put my nose to the grindstone.
Oh, yeah, you do that.
Okay, now I'm ready. Get to work.
Okay.
How were those precious few seconds of jobless freedom?
Oh, magical.
Good. Now get to work.
Really? Okay. But yeah, so far, I mean, she just seems to be friendly with Henry, but, yeah, like, this is the first time that she said that she's gonna draw him. That's not necessarily weird, but it can be. And, it's interesting because Henry's wife also would draw him, and there's a drawing that you come across of him that was drawn by his wife.
Hello, Henry. Having a nice Let's listen. Afternoon.
I might never leave.
Well, I cough with some bad news.
Ooh.
Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week.
These are the teenagers, probably.
They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not gonna be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
Wow, okay. That was fast. Yeah, but those are probably the teenagers that he found skinny dipping in the lake, who were setting off fireworks, and at the time my task was just to get him to stop doing that, and I did, but they were like, "Oh, get out of here, you perv," and yeah, it was just and they didn't have a very positive interaction. There wasn't a lot of positive word choices. Uh-oh. Okay.
Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
What? That's his wife?
I am. I don't know. There's some weird stuff going on.
Oh, that's too bad.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
What was that? That was so weird. Wait, did his wife call him? Is that what just happened? Or is that some kind of weird, sick prank? Man, that was pretty weird. Okay, this just gets weirder by the minute. Hike north to retrieve supplies.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function. So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. And I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation, and I'd just be spoiling it.
Wow.
I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I shouldn't be out here.
Yes, you should.
No, I just ran away from my problems.
No, you didn't. We all fuck up. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Waltz was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine. He'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that. It'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied, and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. I've just lied about it for over 10 years. And, for some reason, I wanted you to know. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Wow. But yeah, just a lot of dialogue in this game that keeps things interesting. Let's see. But of course there was that one weird conversation that they had. Or not really a conversation, but there was a point in the game in the last stream where she interrupts a conversation to pick up a phone, and I think she meant to get off the walkie-talkie, but didn't. And you can hear her talking to some other person. I mean, you can't hear the other person, but she's talking. And she says, oh, he doesn't even know yet. And it sounds like she's talking about you, Henry, the player. So you have some choices there. You could say, hey, who were you talking to? Or, I don't even know what, or just not say a word. I chose not to say a word so that she could just go on thinking that I didn't hear her say that. But so that's just something to keep in mind for anybody tuning in, I guess, during this stream, you know, the second part of this series. Because I don't know how much or if that will affect anything that's going to happen. But it sure seems like it will. And what is this? Supply cache. Also 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. 2 forks. Other lookout. Food for other lookout. I guess this one's mine, huh?
right, I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Day 64. But yeah, you just gotta wonder where this is going. You know, their banter, the way they talk to each other. I mean, are they gonna become an item? I don't know. It's just weird. Give me 1 second.
You've got a
holy crap!
For what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
Holy crap!
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors? So, no ideas, huh?
What?
Delilah's a nice name.
No, you big dummy.
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
I like it.
All right, the June Fire. The June Fire it is.
So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
If I was there with you, I'm sure I would like it a lot.
Are you looking at the fire?
No, I'm not.
You should. Let me know when you are.
I am.
Okay, I'm looking at it again.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
Here.
Me too.
Good. I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. I know it's probably been a while since you've connected with someone the way we have. I don't mean to get all heavy, but...
Is she manipulating me?
It's been really nice. I wish I was over there.
I wish you were too.
We could sit outside. We could talk without these radios. We could, you know.
What? What could we do?
Well, let me tell you.
What the heck? Did I just let that happen? Yeah, things are getting pretty... Yeah. Man.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Does problem actually mean murderer? Like... how Charles Manson is a problem cult leader?
Oh, come on. You just have to look for tracks, that's it.
Yeah, well, I've seen what they can do to a tree, and trees aren't even food.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
Huh. Okay, now I recognize this area. So I'm looking for bear tracks on my way to the lake to go fishing. This is where I had found those girls' clothes, those girls who went skinny dipping, who are now missing. And who might even be dead now. So, the lake is here, that's where they were. Wait, what's that? What's this? Clipboard.
What? Dee, I found a clipboard down here and there's something strange going on.
At the lake?
What?
What's up?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating.
That's weird.
Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo? Oh, God. I don't know why I just called you that.
Oh! Dude! What just happened?
Henry?
I felt that. I almost felt that. I mean...
I got hit in the head, punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
North shore.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you. This just seems like a misunderstanding or something.
Why would I make this up? It's an insane lie at worst and a shitty prank at best.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Okay, I'm sorry, I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were, so what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with a walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who.
She called it a relationship.
What do you think is going on behind that fence?
Apparently a lot of following you around taking notes, which is unfucking believable, Henry.
Yeah, you're telling me. Alright, I'm on my way to Wapiti Meadow.
Ron, got some bad news back at home, so hopefully they'll let me out of here for a while. Who's to say, though, budgets being what they are? Did you get my note about what went down in Wapiti? Sheriff isn't too pleased with me, but I don't know. I probably overdid it. Wish you would have been there. I guess you must have got hung up, David. P.S. Amigos is Spanish for professionales. Amigos is Spanish and professionales is Italian.
I'll let you know what I find.
Okay. There's got to be a reasonable explanation. Also, I'm gonna call around and see if anyone's had anything weird happen to them or seemed spooked. I don't want to make this bigger than it is yet, you know?
Yeah, understood.
Yeah, okay. Hike safe.
Wow, this is pretty weird. Pick up the book, put it back in. Old sweater. University of Eastern Colorado. Can't get the sweater though, it's just there. Put it in there. Close the cache. Okay. So we're going to the North Shore. So I guess I keep going? Man. Things just got really weird. Is there a way to get past that? Can I wade in the water? It doesn't let me. Huh. How am I gonna do this? No? Okay, so I guess I'll go this way. This is the cache I just opened. So which way should I go? Man, things just got seriously... I mean, so she called, would they have a relationship, then said friendship? I mean, I don't know what I did there. I don't know what happened. Okay. Alright, rappelling down. Okay. Huh. Yeah, I seriously have no clue what's going on, but I kind of feel like Delilah is doing something to this guy. I mean, it's more than a prank. I mean, oh, there's a fenced area.
All right, I'm here. Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Get through the fence. Whoa. Long stick. What am I supposed to do with it? Use the stick? Great.
Look, I'm not gonna be able to get into this place. I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Whoa!
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
So I'm supposed to look for some guys to help me get through a fence? Huh. Alright. Let me see. Look for controlled burns south of Ruby River. station. Ruby River. Oh my gosh. That is a long hike. That is one long hike. And this is kind of a dead end. But I don't know. I just think, is that where I'm going? I guess I should just follow the smoke. But yeah, I think Delilah's definitely doing something. And then there's also, I mean, I kind of allowed Henry to get in too deep. With his, I guess, friendship slash relationship with Delilah. So, I don't know what's going to happen. I have no clue. Alright. So I'm going to cross the creek. And I'm going to keep going south. I think we're nearing the area where I got conked in the head. Or yeah, this was it, yeah. So I need to go there. Or medicine wheel. Where's the burn? Where's the smoke? There it is. The June fire.
Whoa, the June fire isn't going anywhere, huh?
No, that's why those guys came out to burn that line. It's at the stage where all we can do is pay attention to it.
They're not gonna try to put it out?
Not yet, apparently.
Huh. I think this is a new path. Let me see. So, I guess I can take a left? Let me see. Will it even let me? Man, I think it's blocked off. I don't think I can even go that way. Maybe I better go back. But yeah, I kind of let Henry get in a little too deep with Delilah. But now they have just been talking, though. But I don't know, I guess talking goes a long way. Okay. So, let's see. I have no idea where I'm going, folks.
I'm wandering around east of the lake. Which way is Ruby River?
It's in the southeast corner of your map. The scout camp where the firefighters were staged should be on your map. It looks like a little triangle with a flat bottom.
Yeah, it looks like a tent.
How did I never see that before?
And... huh. Wait a minute, so I should go this way? Let me see. I think I need to go this way.
Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Well, are the other lookouts telling the truth?
Why wouldn't they be?
I don't know. Maybe someone told them not to.
You're suggesting that you and I are actually being watched by whom exactly?
I don't know, obviously.
Someone who is telling folks I've worked with for years to lie? Big Brother is not casting a shadow on the Shoshone, Henry.
Look, you should have seen this clipboard, Delilah.
Yeah, I guess I should have.
All right. I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
Hey, well, you just said keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry...
it's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I'm not, okay? Let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
Things are just getting weirder and weirder. I want to go to that medicine wheel. I don't know what that is. Let's check it out.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scary it would have been.
Wow, there's an old, I think it's called a medicine wheel out here?
Yeah, it was made by Crow American Indians hundreds of years ago. There are lots of small ones. Have you ever been to Medicine Wheel Monument over in the Bighorns?
Hey, maybe he'd actually enjoy it. Spies, taking notes, walkie-talkies. Whole thing might actually be fun if you're too young to realize how creepy it is.
That's one way of looking at it.
He's fine. It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Hmm. So go east. Yeah, she was just referencing another lookout who was out there with his son 3 years ago. She got along with the son, but not with the dad, and she's thinking something might have happened to them. Okay. I'm getting there now. Yeah? Controlled burn. And a supply box. Great. See what we have here. Terminal 7. Another copy of Jane Eyre. One chance to die. Toilet paper. Anything else? Pine cone. Okay, I guess I'll just copy that. Whoop! That's not what I meant to do. Library, and I guess I already have that part of the map. Find firefighters in an old scout camp past controlled burn.
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to Two Forks now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Ugh, are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
Scout camp. Okay. Guess I'm going east. Alright, here we go. What is that?
There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah, where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den, or, you know, anywhere.
Right. So I continue my trek. Camp Arapaho. Nice.
bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
So...
Camp Arapaho.
You're there?
Yeah, I am.
It's been out there since the 50s.
I was never really into the idea of the scouts. It's something about men organizing boys around their ideals. Or is that right with me?
Beware of weebelows in large numbers.
Beware of anyone in large numbers.
Don't drop down. Oh boy. Okay.
To any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
I mean, he wasn't a scout or a weeblow or whatever?
I got the sense that boy could barely tie his shoes, let alone a clove hitch.
What the hell's a clove hitch?
Well, it's a knot that you are probably too old and too stubborn to learn. You use it to make rafts and shelters and stuff like that.
Huh. You know how to tie one?
Heck no. I'd make a weeblow do it.
I guess these little shelters are where they keep the weeblows.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
There are bear traps out here in the scout shelters.
Scouts are stalwart prey.
That's messed up.
Huh. Anyway, this is kind of weird. Scout camp, pork pond. Where are these guys? I guess they never said... I guess Delilah never said that they were going to be in the scout camp, but I don't know where else to look. Camp Arapaho. Where else can I go? I'll try to go beyond the camp, but I don't know how far beyond it'll let me go. Yeah, it doesn't... Wait a minute, where... Is this another path?
Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Damn.
I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge help.
For both getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Okay. And what is this memo?
Hey, D, they left something behind.
Squad boss Carson, Wapiti Station, Thoroughfare Region, squad boss Carson. In the next few days, you and your team will be dropping into the Thoroughfare Region of Shoshone National Forest to cut a fire line south of Ruby River. I'm writing you on behalf of Dr. Ben Simmons at Wapiti Station. He reached out to the superintendent with wildfire concerns about his research site. Upon your return, someone from his office will want to speak with you as part of a wildfire risk assessment of the region. I told them they have nothing to worry about and that your team's fire lines are the most potent preventative measure in protecting their site, even though they'll be more than a mile away. But I think they've got insurance companies to answer to. Thanks as always for your service. Okay.
It's like a memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the Thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there and let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would need someone to give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Us. They're researching us.
That's weird.
You think they're studying you and me?
I do, yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what'd they do?
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
Man, this is really messed up. Alright. So, we gotta go back to Wapiti Meadow. Wapiti Station. Huh. Just look out, and I'm way down here. So right now I gotta go westward. Northwest. Okay. I can do that. Here we go. But yeah, I think Delilah is somehow in on it. I don't think she's totally innocent, but I don't know. I honestly have no clue. How can I get across? I guess I can jump over this, no? It's not letting me. Huh. I really don't know how to get back. Can't cross here. Well, I know that, but... How else will I get across? Alright. And that's as far as it lets me go. Seriously? Okay. What about this? No. No, I can't get... No, I can't cross that way either. This is... Long drop. Well, yeah, this is how I got here. But it's like you can only get across one way. Wait a minute. Damaged tree. Chopped down. Of course. Yeah. Okay. Cool beans. So that was it. Okay. All right, I did it.
Are you there? I had a thought.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh,
fuck.
There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
That's freaking creepy. That is freaking creepy. This is just getting really scary. Man. I mean, not like in a horror kind of way, but it's still scary. I guess we'll see where this goes. We'll see how far the rabbit hole goes, I suppose. That was a lot of rhyming.
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today. The June fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
I didn't sleep a wink last night, and I've been going crazy for the past 6 hours of sunup. How are you so chipper?
Well, it's a new day. What a day, this day we've been given.
Maybe I am actually asleep right now. Maybe I didn't stay up all night knowing that someone is...
I actually slept just great.
Okay.
By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
All right.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
Great. Just wonderful. Do you see the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Let me look at it and I'll tell you.
No. You don't need to tell me. Just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
Oh, yeah, okay. Maybe I should go for a hike.
Nothing like an afternoon in the Rockies, I tell ya. Radio me the moment you get there.
Man. Okay, that was smart. Yeah, that was... Okay. We're in full-on paranoia mode because we're both pretty sure we're being listened to and or watched. So Cottonwood Creek, where was that? Let me see. Cottonwood Creek, Thunder Canyon, Basin, Bear Point. That's Ruby River. Campfire Smoke, Jonesy Lake, Thunder Canyon. Wapiti Meadow, Supply Drop. Seriously, where's Cottonwood Creek? I have no idea where it is. Which way? Oh, okay, got it. So I'm going south again. Okay, I can do that. And here we go. Okay. Man. I have no idea what's going on here. But it's getting pretty creepy. I mean, is Delilah still, you know, with the enemy here? Or is she being played too? I mean, other than the talking, I mean, has he been fooling, Henry been fooling around with Delilah? I mean, I really hope not. Okay. And this is where? Cottonwood Creek. So I cross, and then I'm gonna make a left. But, okay. Okay, yeah, I gotta get through this part. that me making those noises? Okay. Whoa, okay, I gotta go in the opposite direction. Not towards the snowmobiles. And the creek should be coming up any minute now. That tree looks pretty creepy. Reminds me of the tree from The Ring. There's the creek. At least I think that's the creek. Yeah? That's it. So we're here. I guess I can cross it on foot. I mean, huh. Okay, so I'm here. I'm not getting a prompt to talk to Delilah yet, though. Cache. Maybe I can go to the cache. Okay. So go north.
I'm here at Cottonwood Creek.
Oh.
You see the cash box there?
It must be around here somewhere.
It is. Find it and open it. I changed the code. It's 5678.
Are you kidding me?
I was in a rush.
Okay. Map updated. Three blind rats? Oh, it's a book. I actually thought I was gonna find three blind. New radio.
I've got it now.
Good. I spent all day getting you that radio. I hiked to a cash box, lied to a ranger, lied to another ranger. Hopefully you are now holding a clean, untapped radio.
Hopefully.
Holy fuck, Henry. We have to get into that site.
What the fuck is going on? People are listening to us?
I don't know.
Our radios are tapped? Are you fucking serious?
Our radios are definitely tapped. That's why I left you the one you just got.
How is this even possible?
I don't know, Henry.
What do you know? Are there any other lookouts this is happening to? Someone else in on this? Anyone?
This is just happening to us. Everyone else is fine.
Are you sure?
Yes. I've tried to bring it up to Chimney Rock, Elk's Fork, and Beartooth Lookout, and every one of them got confused. Asked me if I'm okay and if I need to be relieved. Our fucking state coordinator asked if I was just having lady troubles. So no.
What?
This is happening to anyone else, and I'm done asking. None of it makes any sense.
Look, I'm headed back to the gate, and now that I've got an axe, we'll know something soon.
You need to get into that site. Call me when you find something.
Man. Break into Wapiti Meadow. Okay, so I guess I can go that way. I can actually just go this way then. And go back to the meadow, big tree. Okay. Yeah. I was already sort of on the right track when I was still in the creek. So that's what I'll do. But yeah, this is getting very interesting. wonder where this is all going, folks. Seriously, I mean, I don't know what's going on. The story is getting very good. I hope it doesn't end in something anticlimactic. I mean, there's real good potential here, but I just hope it doesn't get ruined at the end. Let me see. So I am... Okay, cool. So I'm gonna get to the medicine wheel, I guess. There it is. Cool.
Hey. I just thought of something not great.
Great.
What is it?
I filed a report that said that neither of us ever talked to or saw those girls, the ones that went missing a few weeks back.
What? Why would you do that? I told you to say the minimum and just keep it vague.
I know. And I didn't. I just didn't want to be hassled.
And now someone probably has a transcript of that entire conversation.
And I've filed a report that's a blatant lie.
Oh, and those girls are still missing.
Yep.
Fuck, Delilah.
Fuck, indeed. Shit. We really need to get to the bottom of this.
Man. This is really messy.
I just heard something.
What is it?
I don't know. It was goddamn terrifying, though.
Well, it could be an elk, or it could be someone trying to get you to radio about a loud noise so they know where you are.
Ah, fuck.
How about you don't do that again?
Shit. Didn't know they could do that. Okay, so I guess I'm going to Jonesy Lake still. Here we go. Okay, so I'm at Jonesy Lake. And from here, I can just keep going north. Okay, cool beans. That's simple enough. This is where I got conked in the head. Somewhere around here, anyway. Right past the log. That's where it happened. Okay, going north. Man, the particle effects in this game are actually pretty good. And... is it gonna let me get past this? Yes. So... I think I have to go east now. Yes. Okay. Rappel down into the ravine. Here we go. Here we go. Here is the fence.
I'm busting the gate down. There's nobody around, and it's the quickest way in.
Copy that.
I smashed open the gate. Should I try to fix or hide this?
No, screw it.
Okay, then.
Whoa! Ow!
Clipboard.
I got stung by a bee.
Okay.
Okay.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Did it hurt?
Yes, kind of.
Okay, I'm sorry.
If you're trying to reach Dr. Simmons, he is on site from August 15th to October 15th. University-owned equipment is the responsibility of Dr. Johnson. Government-owned equipment is under the purview of Cat Ferdinand. Remember, this is a controlled area, and any issues, malfunctions, or violations should be reported immediately. Okay, I guess I'm going to keep that. Okay, so I'm in some government research site. And I don't know what it's about. But we think it might have to do with the girls that have gone missing and people in here might be investigating us, or they're investigating us because of the events that are occurring behind this fence. Okay, what is that? Okay.
Okay, I'm at the site. I don't see anybody around.
Lucky for us.
Yeah, lucky for us. There is some serious comms equipment out here, wireless stuff.
What do you mean?
I'm talking a big 20-foot-tall transmission tower. And they could probably listen to whoever the hell they want. They're nestled down in this valley, which makes it impossible for you or any lookout to see them.
Wait, what is that?
Now they're doing something with the soil out here too. It's all gridded off.
Who knows what else they're up to?
There's all sorts of contraptions and shit out here.
Like what?
Dishes and stuff on metal legs. There are wires all over the place. I don't know. I'm not really up on high tech. I mean, how the hell did they get all this stuff out here?
The Army Corps of Engineers put our towers out here, so...
You think it was the government?
I have no idea. I just mean it's possible. I mean... Every once in a while, I'll meet a lookout who's deep into that, like, black helicopter conspiracy shit. Maybe they actually flew it out here in one of those.
I'm in their main tent. I wonder where they are. All of their stuff is here.
And they know you're there, so see what you can find and get out.
I think I found the thing they used to track us.
Holy shit!
You know, you swear, like, a lot.
Not the time, Hank.
Anyway, it's called a... wave receiver. Looks like it picks up anything that emits a signal. It's got basic orienteering capabilities, everything. Holy
shit, Henry.
Yeah, holy shit.
You're gonna take it, right?
Yeah, of course. Okay, this thing is losing its mind, beeping like crazy.
I can hear it. What's it after?
I don't know. I'm gonna go find out. This place sleeps three. They've got a row of cots here.
I wanna know what what that thing finds. Look, you should get out before they come back.
I found their main monitoring desk.
You should get out before they come back.
I think this thing is responding to something in this pile of crap on the desk.
Dig through it.
Subjects Henry and Delilah? Oh my gosh. Delilah, age 43, too weak. Henry, too... What the hell is that?
Are you shitting me?
What? What is it?
There's a folder of reports here.
What do they say?
There is...
Observations from charismatic. Who is this? Delilah? Skewed perception of personal history. Never married, never really hikes, or leaves a man. Multiple lovers despite lifetime partner. Javier. Susceptibility to manipulation is 3. Whoa.
Investments about the two of us. There's stuff in here about Julia.
Like what?
Stuff I didn't tell you.
Keeps to the path, prone to anger, passive, guilty, forthright, guarded, engaged, that's willing to engage in trust yet to be said. Sets point towards full cooperation. Subject may be aware of tests, suggest gauge if subject decides to leave his post. Oh my gosh! Susceptibility to manipulation 9?
This is...
What does it say about me? You said there was one about me.
And it looks like they've been following me around. What I do when I'm out hiking? Jesus!
Henry, do you hear me?
Since you and your boyfriend are still together.
What? We're not. They're messing with us.
Yeah, okay.
They are. How do they even know who he is? How the hell does this... I'm so sick of letting these people do this to us. We should just burn the place down. Think about it.
Delilah.
What? Think about it.
I am. And I think it's insane.
They'd be fucked.
Yeah, and how about if that fire comes up the mountain? Or someone were to die in it?
We call it in?
We call it in?
Yeah, maybe.
My God, Delilah, no. No way.
Well, maybe it's not the best idea.
Yeah, no, it's not.
Definitely.
Not the best idea.
Ah, so fucking wound up.
It's all right. I'm just gonna... hike back. We have the wave receiver, and tomorrow we can figure out what to do.
Two Forks Lookout. Something tells me that it's not going to be that easy to get out of here. Okay. This is just too easy. I mean, there's got to be somebody around here. Gonna want to conk me in the head. This just seems way too easy. Okay. Oh no. Oh no, 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 no!
Whoa. Oh, shit! Delilah, there's smoke coming from the site. I just climbed out of there and the bridge collapsed.
What the hell happened to you? It's definitely not the best idea.
It wasn't me.
What do we do?
We just call it in like any other fire.
And what about who started it? What about them?
Person who started it?
Yeah.
We're talking about people watching us out here who are now burning the forest and everything in it around us. I don't know what to do about that.
Except get the hell out.
Yes, get us the hell out of here.
I will.
Man. Yeah, that's pretty messed up. I don't know how this is gonna end, folks. This is getting pretty intense. But, yeah, things look very extremely just beyond sinister, I'd say. What the heck? Who is this?
This receiver just picked something up.
Like a signal? It's going beep beep.
Yeah, what could it be?
I don't know. You gotta find out.
All right, I'm on my way now.
You know what I just picked up?
No.
A fifth of Major Bueno tequila from the creek.
Oh, crap.
Are you drunk?
No! I am getting drunk!
Don't do that!
I know, I know. Everything has gone to total shit, but you gotta live a little. You gotta allow, Hank.
Wedding
no,
ring?
No, you're right, Dee. I can't think of any good reason why you wouldn't want your decision-making inhibited right now.
My thinking is, I could stay up all night worried I'm gonna lose my job because of the side fire, or I could not worry and let the chips fall where they may. It's not like there's any proof we were down there.
My thinking is, I'm gonna follow this wave receiver.
Ooh, I like it when you think.
Ay, ay, ay. I'll just leave you alone with whatever these thoughts are. Last thing I need is another big crossword breakthrough.
Radio off. Man. Now I'm on my own. No more Delilah. I'm thinking they know I took this thing. I don't know which way to go. Is going crazy. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, what is this?
Shit.
Oh!
What?
Oh! Cave 452. It's that cave I couldn't get.
Dee, I found some sort of supply bag. Light camping gear, some clothes, and basics. It was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
Yeah, I'm fine. But there's also a set of keys here. I don't know why they'd be hidden out here. They say Shoshone National Forest, Cave 452. Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah, it is. Who the hell took them?
And what the hell is in that cave?
Okay, let's just think.
Says the woman with a half a bottle of tequila in her belly.
Maybe they're panicking and we're preparing to beat it. But the fire has them spooked and we have new walkie-talkies, so we have the upper hand.
Yeah, well, it's hard to feel like you have the upper hand when you're standing in the dark in the middle of the woods.
Oh. Well, you're back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
What?
I'm not in my tower.
I am looking at a man standing in your lookout, and it's not you.
It is not me.
Oh my god, go.
I'm going.
Oh crap. Okay. Here you go. How am I getting... Oh my gosh. Right. Whoa. What the? Where am I? Did I just go in a circle? Okay. No. I'm on the right track. I think I'm on the right track. Someone is in my tower. And where is my tower? Shouldn't it be visible from here? Yes, there it is. There it is. Holy cow.
Hey, is that person still up there?
No, he's gone.
All right.
Crap.
I'm close. I just didn't want to run into him.
Yeah. Look, be careful.
I'll call you when I get up there.
She could be lying. I mean, the person could be up there.
I don't see anyone up here.
She was just there.
Left a cassette player taped to my damn door.
I don't even know what to say to that.
Well, let's see what's on it.
Crap. All right, let's see.
It's a tape of us talking down at the site.
It's manipulated.
Sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
Dee, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh my God, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
This is seriously messed up. Yeah, I mean, that was an obviously manipulated recording. Yeah, I don't know what to make of it, folks. I don't know where the story is going.
Together, okay? Keep our story straight. From the first day with those girls to the person breaking in on our conversation, everything. We gotta be honest and consistent.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
I know.
All right. Okay, so I'm going to the cave. So I guess I just go eastward. Yeah. Eastward and then north. Actually, 452. No, just go north. drop down. Here we go. Okay. This is where I
book. Hey, you didn't actually make that call, right? To the other lookout? It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kind of just wish I hadn't.
Of course I didn't. No way. They're trying to pit us against each other.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
That's not gonna happen, though.
Okay. Okay, so this is it. All right. So we'll finally figure out what's behind this cave.
What the hell?
Wait, what is this? There was another long drop that I could have taken, I think. I have to go check that out.
Well, Jesus, this is a big cave.
It doesn't let you drop, though. Yeah, no, you can't really go that way. So, squeeze through.
It's freezing in here.
Huh. Okay. Climb up. And we go this way. Yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna find here. The suspense is killing me, folks, seriously. What is this?
Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus!
So you didn't find anything?
No, there's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes. I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous.
That was that long, steep drop. Wait, what is this?
Delilah, I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Really?
Yeah, he built himself a real castle. A bunch of rocks stacked up, he made a wall and a perimeter.
God. Yeah, that's perfect.
He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left. There's a busted old toy out here, some sort of electronic game.
Goodwin's.
Yeah? I like Pong.
Everybody likes Pong. It's a little weird that he'd just leave so much of his stuff out here.
Well, maybe they were in a hurry when they left. Like I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied, and just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to.
Huh. Brian stole his dad's climbing gear, his anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was gonna hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it.
Hi, my name is Brian Goodwin. If you found this note, it should be with a bunch of climbing anchors. I hope you do me a favor and please return them to me, Brian Goodwin, in the mail. My address is 55 Foxtrot Lane, North Platte, Nebraska, 69101. If you tell me your name and address, I will give you a reward for this. You're probably wondering why I left these here. Well, they are my dad's, and I don't want him to lose them, but I don't want to do any more climbing on this trip, so I thought I should pretend to lose them. But if you help me get them back, everyone will be happy. Thank you for your time. Thank you, Ranger Brian. The reward will be good.
He left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah. It sounds like Ned was pushing him, and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. What an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put it past old Ned.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also, he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
There's some grade A dork contraband here.
You found his pocket protector?
I found a data sheet for one Gladius Silva, half-elf, armor 7.
Classic wizards and wyverns.
Yeah, between this and the map I found in my tower, old Brian created quite the fantasy world.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved out there.
Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
What, you're saying I'm one of those knuckleheads, is that it?
I wasn't, but, now that I think about it...
If the shoe fits!
Because I know lots of stuff.
Oh, please, drown me in your surplus of knowledge. I've been waiting all these years for a man as wise as you to take this job.
Well, that wait's over, sweetheart. Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
It's some Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much.
Hmm. So that's what that is.
I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler.
Ham radio waves off and blah 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 blah. Because my science meteor scatter communications, my science fair project proves that meteor scatter communications. What is it? MSC is a radio propagation mode that utilizes the ionized trails of meteors within our atmosphere. Meteors upon their atmospheric entry can create a dense path of ionized particles that the ham radio operator can use to establish brief communication paths between operators up to 1,500 miles away. It's pretty cool. I'm going to have a small chat with a friend my dad made in the Army who lives in Albuquerque, New Mexico, 1,000 miles from my house. We're going to try to talk at a regular time, but my hypothesis is that that won't work and we will have to wait for a meteor shower so we can establish a communication, blah, blah, blah. Okay. can't take the video game. Or the seat cushion. The banner.
He'd hide out here to read comics. The black band, his grief is his enemy's sorrow.
Huh.
Everyone this guy loves gets killed, so he honors them with a black armband, which gives him superpowers.
Well, that's fucking dark.
Any prompt at all? Any prompt whatsoever? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, so that's what you wanted me to do. Well, that took me long enough. Okay, I'm just glad I finally figured that out.
What do you think is in there?
I don't know, really. I mean, we gotta find out. What do you think?
Whatever it is, they don't want you telling anyone about.
They closed the door when they could have just...
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
Are you serious with this shit right now?
A hatchet. God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
Honestly, I just want to know. I want to know what is worth doing everything that's been done to us.
Yeah, me too. And not going to jail would be a nice kicker.
Okay. So I guess I have to go back to the cave entrance.
Also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them.
Yay!
Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and, landed in jail.
Dodged a bullet there.
Yeah, we've got enough unanswered shit to answer for, I'd say.
Right. Whoa. Is this the same cave? Yeah, it is. 452. All right, here we go again. So here, all right. All right, here we go. The deep part of the cave. This is where we're supposedly going to find out why everything has been happening. Drop down. Shaft of light. Ominous music. Let's get ready, folks. What? Oh man. It's Brian Goodwin. He's not gonna report it? Oh, man. Poor kid. But that still doesn't explain why. Okay, maybe it suggests that people knew that Delilah had actually known that there was a minor in the park when he shouldn't have been. Get out of the cave and report the body. Climb rocks. Man, poor kid. Drop down. Okay. Climb rocks.
Hey, D.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
Hey, you, might want to take a seat.
I've been sitting this entire time. I'm almost always sitting. What's wrong?
The only thing in the cave was a body.
A body? God, what a mess.
Delilah. It's Brian Goodwin.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing? I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's just what it was. He was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. Whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. I'm sorry, Delilah. I'm so sorry.
He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
Dude, this is heavy. Yeah, that was... Yeah. I don't know, I'm speechless, folks. All right. Pack up belongings.
You see that plane?
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
What, is this the June fire or the site fire?
The two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
about how all this stuff is connected. The surveillance, the Goodwins, Brian's death.
Look, I don't know what to say, okay? It's like the universe cooked up the cruelest thing to have happen. Does it connect to everything else? I don't know. I don't know if I even want to.
Of course you do. There's gotta be a reason.
Does there?
Maybe. Maybe not. I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Well, fuck. For starters, I guess you could find the source of that signal.
Holy crap. Yeah. Oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us. Whoever made the tape.
Okay. Yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
All right, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Okay.
What's your status?
I think I'm getting close.
All right. Well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cutback in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
Okay.
Someone left a rope for me to climb up. I'm down near the lake.
How do you know it's for you?
There's a tracking collar tied to it. Someone was leading me here. And there's another tape.
Oh my god, Henry.
Yeah, hi, Henry. Hey, you better find this before it burns up. We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Now I gotta go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for croc's sake.
Down by the cave.
I've been up here for 3 years.
3 years?
I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and I ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and... Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two.
Who is this?
You guys don't know anything about having kids. All right, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down the lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him.
It's Ned.
Ryan was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer
that
questions,
dead.
Having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
We found the surveillance operation.
It's Ned Goodwin.
What does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
Ned Goodwin? He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. Deeper into the Shoshone, he doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son.
He's... got a survival bunker with radios and everything. He made it all up.
Huh.
You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay. You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands. This boombox looks familiar. He was rigging up stolen batteries to keep his stuff going.
Huh. Radio logs.
He wrote down everything he did to us. Everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
I bet.
Huh. He's got a radio base station up here. He was listening to us on that. He had quite the view.
That is at 22,000 acres and growing fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well, take a picture if you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
I don't know.
Forgot how to do that. Hey, look, there's my watchtower. Okay. Huh. Drake North. Evac point. That is south. I should go north. Clothesline. Doesn't really let me go north. I guess I have to go south first. Okay. Propel. Okay, that's right. That's where I came from. Northwest. North. Okay. Here we go. Did I even go this way? I remember this. West, north. West, southwest. Let's see. So, all right.
I know
go.
I should be relieved. Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. He was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
I think that Ned loved him. He obviously didn't want to forget him. He just didn't know what to do.
Henry, not knowing what to do isn't okay. When you're supposed to look after someone,
you figure it out.
Yes. And Ned Goodwin is a shithead who is incapable of figuring anything out. Sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
Station.
You didn't do anything wrong. You said it yourself. It was Ned's job to look after him.
Yes, I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
Pete?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah?
I mean, it's dangerous here, and if anything were to happen, then that would be on me, so...
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, you sure that's okay?
I said it was.
All right, I should go.
Have a safe flight.
All right, have a safe hike.
Man... Which way? So just follow the canyon. That's what I'll do. Alright. Man, I have no sense of direction for this. Let's see. So this should take me to the canyon, right? Yes. And okay. Okay, on the right track. Here we go. How far am I? Okay, almost there. Almost there. Come on. And now I am okay. Still not there, but almost. Oh, I can climb. Here we go. Climb rocks. Delilah's Tower. There we go. Okay, now I can see where I'm going. Except that I can't go very fast, but... go that way, apparently. And okay. So I'll get to see her tower, apparently. Further north. Can go that way. Come on. Box. Have I come across this one yet? Yes. I guess. Oh, there it is. The climb. Supply drop box. This is further north. There. Is this it?
Hey, I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there?
I guess she's not.
Delilah?
So now what? Black screen? That can't be the end. And it's not. Have a good time. Nice.
Hello? Is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me. I'm back at the staging area near the trailhead. I think I see your truck.
Red? Colorado plates?
Yeah. It's a piece of shit.
Well, yeah.
I think there might be a raccoon living in it.
Make sure he's comfy, I guess.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Ah, shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me and I'll choose for you?
All right.
Okay.
Sure. Maybe... Well, you'd make a great shrink.
Are you kidding me? You spent 10 weeks with me, and God knows how much therapy it's going to take to undo this experience.
Well, you're a good conversationalist, I guess.
Thanks. I try.
I mean, you definitely still have some stuff to learn at shrink school. Like, a lot of stuff.
Noted.
So, what about me, then?
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
I, yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Yeah, sure.
Henry, I... Look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
You're right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could,
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year, we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
Yeah?
Well, you should try to take her advice, too.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
I'll see you when I see you.
Yeah, okay. Sounds good.
Okay.
Bye, Hank.
That, folks, has been Firewatch. Man, what a trip. Yeah. But it's interesting how one of the choices was to not go back and see the wife with Alzheimer's. I mean, the game has so many choices you can make. It even kind of asks, hey, do you want to pursue this relationship with the person you've been on the phone with? I didn't take that many pictures. But, yeah, folks. So there it is, Firewatch. I hope you enjoyed the stream, this two-parter. It certainly was, you know, one of the emotionally heavier games that I've played in recent years. I really enjoyed it. It was great. And please make sure to catch this stream on YouTube. Or you may already be doing that if you're watching this. But either way, however you're watching this, thanks for watching. I am Rui Diaz Mio Cid. This is Rui Diaz Gaming. And I will catch you later. Ciao.